50 miles an hour, you can see it glowing brightly in the sky. And in just a few moments, we're going to reach peak heating, a phenomenal view of that streaking SRC coming in across the sky.
We have confirmed parachute deployment.
Wow. And after an exhilarating streak across Earth's atmosphere, we have parachute deployment. You can see just a sigh of relief from the team. I can hear some applause here. There is that orange creamsicle-colored parachute. The reaction there just moments ago as they got that sample back on the ground. This is the team at Lockheed celebrating that momentous achievement of getting that sample. You can see front and center there, Stu Wiley, our on-scene commander, and right behind him is Victoria team. They are both wearing personal protective equipment, gas masks. That's for their own safety as they approach, as there could be potential outgassing from that sample return capsule's batteries heating up during reentry. You can see him scanning the region. He's checking for any possible unexploded ordnances, UXOs.
Recovery operations. OSIRIS performing the unexploded ordnance survey.
And you just heard that he is, in fact, doing that survey right now. You can see him walking around the SRC. Got that SRC, as you can see, successfully on the ground. It is perfectly resting on the desert terrain. You can see we have the cargo netting already laid out there. Our representative from Dugway, Jasmine Nakayama, is prepared with that cargo netting. She is going to help the team here get that SRC that has already been successfully bagged up with thermal wrapping into that cargo netting. And you can see the helicopter already there, staged and ready to lift off.
Recovery operations. Helicopter 1 is cleared to depart the recovery site with the SRC.
And we have clearance to depart the recovery site. This is a key moment of those recovery operations. We're already getting that SRC out of the landing zone and on its way to the Dugway clean room. In just a few moments, that SRC, with the long line attached, will be lifting off its landing zone. Jasmine assisting with that final part of the lift, and it is now airborne. As I mentioned, a much more relaxing flight for our SRC on its last leg of its journey. You can see a wonderful view of the SRC in the cargo netting. That metal piece on the bottom is the carrying fixture that helps team members actually carry this SRC. In just a few moments, the SRC will be back on the ground. Its second touchdown of the day, a much calmer one than we had earlier this morning. And you see two members approaching, grabbing that cargo netting to get the SRC on the ground. And in just a few seconds, we will have a release of that long line. And there you have it. This last step of the process of getting the SRC opened up, accessing the sample canister within, getting it on a nitrogen purge. And then actually tomorrow morning, we'll have a C-17 cargo plane flying this precious cargo down to the Johnson Space Center. In just a second here, you can see our team members moving that a little bit closer. The doors are now open. We are entering into the clean room, and that SRC is about to be moved off onto our clean room fixture. Our clean room team members carrying that SRC in, and these doors will be slammed shut just as soon as we can get that SRC fixture out, and there we go. It is in the clean room. The SRC from the desert of Utah, earlier this morning arriving, has been successfully delivered to the Dugway portable clean room. You can just see just how charred that SRC back shell and heat shield are. A great close-up angle here. You can really see our prized sample return capsule at long last in the clean room. It's hard to fathom that just a couple years ago, this sample return capsule that you see here was over 200 million miles away from us on the other side of the solar system. The OSIRIS-REx spacecraft worked to quickly stow the sample it got from the asteroid Bennu at sample site Nightingale into this sample return capsule. We slammed that lid shut and prepared it for the long journey back. It took 1.2 billion miles to get from the asteroid Bennu after sample collection to Earth's atmosphere. We entered in 82 miles off the surface of San Francisco, went through the punishing entry, descent, landing, landed in the desert, and now here we have it, the sample return capsule in our clean room. The team's gonna move this a little bit over to the center of the room so they can all gather around and begin the process of removing that back shell and then ultimately getting the heat shield off as well.
What you saw executed today, that precision, everything going just almost perfectly to plan, that happens because of an incredible team. Hundreds and hundreds of people.
We heard passing through 100,000 feet, passing through 60,000 feet, and I was getting a little worried for sure. I knew things were supposed to be happening on a nominal timeline, that I wasn't getting call outs, but again, we could have just had radio dropouts there. And then we heard main chute detected, and I literally broke into tears. I mean, and I'm probably going to do it right now just thinking about it, because that was the moment I knew we made it home. And, you know, I'm weary at this point. I've been thinking about this and focusing on it, and all of my energy and all of my will has gone into making this thing a success. But it was like seeing an old friend that you hadn't seen for a long time, and it was great to see it. It was just great to see it. I did want to give it a hug, but you know, I knew I'd be all sooty, and we were trying to collect environmental samples, so that really wouldn't have gone over well. But yeah, it was amazing. I was there when it was encapsulated in the fairing. I was there when it was assembled and when it was installed on the spacecraft. I was there when it was nothing but a PowerPoint on a slide in a proposal that we were submitting to NASA with this dream that we were going to bring back samples from Bennu. So it was amazing and emotional. I've been emotional all day, and that was one of the key moments for me.